After the presidential directive that bans more cutting of trees, especially from the national forests, recently, the National Forestry Authority is set to implement this directive. They have procured equipment worth over 1.6 billion, including field vehicles, motorbikes, GPS systems, and many others that are intended to boost and strengthen their enforcement, as confirmed by the board chairman, National Forestry Authority, Engineer Dr. Ebal Christopher, and the executive director, Tom Okello, while commissioning this equipment.
Last time, we were on a transformation agenda to make sure we increase the forest coverage. The AED has already said from some years back, to within 2 years, we want to make sure we are at 15. Now it's about 13. Now, when you are doing that, and you only have the human resources, and you don't give them the necessary tools, then you won't succeed. So what you are witnessing today is part of the transformation agenda.
We are here to flag off a fleet of transport equipment in terms of vehicles and motorcycles that have been procured to be deployed in the field for sustainable management of the forest resources.
They appeal to the public to desist from cutting trees for charcoal and advise them to embrace available clean energy briquettes.
So saying, people are crying that charcoal is not there, the prices has increased, and he's also wondering, Grace is wondering whether we have implemented the presidential ban. I think that's why people are crying. The ban is being implemented. Already we have got another guidelines on how to move from the Prime Minister and also from the Minister of Water and Environment. So that ban is being implemented. And I want to say, for everything that you do, there must be a single step. The first step must be done. I also want to leave you with one question. What will happen if all the trees are cut?
They caution their staff who are going to use this equipment to handle it with care and only use it for the intended objective of protect forests.
Aspect of limited funding. So certain activities, you cannot carry them on. The next thing you need to know that these five vehicles are just part of the many. Last time we flagged almost 30 here, and that is how we are moving. So this one will not go throughout the country. These ones are going to particular areas only.
They further warned forest rangers who on several occasions connive with degraders that they will be reprimanded.
We are talking about is our staff. As NFA, we don't give any tolerance to corruption. Any of our staff who connives with anybody to cut trees, we take disciplinary action. And if you want to know the details, there are some who have been dismissed.
There are people who are creating titles in forest reserves and then they sell to somebody who is unsuspecting. Then when the person comes, you find we're in direct conflict with that person. So I want you to inform Ugandans, when you are buying land in Buganda and the title is free, old title created few years ago, first come to us and bring that title, we check for you. Don't buy before we check for you.
National Forestry Authority is aiming at increasing the forest cover from 13% to 15% by the year 2025 through promotion of private tree planting and encouraging more people to plant in demarcated forest reserves. Report compiled by Ismail Subuga for the news.